something to do in just a second, but I want to ask one more question. So I was watching you do stand-up, and you're very good.
I was mortified with that set when you were there in Montreal.
Why? But I still remember the story. About skydiving and jerking off.
Oh, okay. All right.
Are you mortified about that?
No.
So what? I was watching, and you said this was your fiance? Was this the same girl that you're talking about?
We've been engaged ever since. And
that was the moment? That's how you broke it to her?
Well, no. Where did
you meet this person?
I met her on a job. She works in production in the art department. She's a prop stylist and a wardrobe. Right. So we met on a job. It was Super Bowl related in January of 2017. And, you know, we've been together ever since. It's my first relationship that's lasted over 1 year. Wow. In my life.
And has it been a smooth road of a relationship?
It's been pretty smooth.
Do you have a date set?
We don't. I mean, the pandemic really kind of bungled that up a little bit because...
Really? Yeah. Really? The reason you didn't get married was because of the pandemic. With all the shit that you do each and every day for a movie, the pandemic was... Are you vaccinated?
I'm fully vaccinated, yeah.
Fantastic.
As of May 14th, I had my second shot. But because we're both, me and my girl, her name is Lux, by the way. Lux and I are both so convinced, so sure that we don't want to have kids. I went ahead and filmed one of my stunts for my new comedy tour. It was the Vasectomy Olympics. You know, I went about and got a vasectomy, and then immediately after my vasectomy in a hospital gown, I got on a horse and it galloped bareback with just my balls bouncing up and down off the horse, and then we dressed me up as a piñata in my hospital gown and gave kids sticks to whack me in the balls as I was hung upside down from a tree. It was hilarious. You know, this whole idea of not having kids, what I decided...
Wait. You can't move on from that. You had an actual vasectomy.
Yeah.
So I've never had one, but my friends who have had one, they do it with a laser, right?
They didn't do it with the laser. I got it in Puerto Rico for what it's worth.
But did you save money?
No.
So what do they do in Puerto Rico? So tell me, you go to Puerto Rico, because I want to hear...
And it wasn't... I suppose you can get it with a laser. In my case, it was...
But in Puerto Rico, they don't do it. How do they do it? The guy just bites your nuts off?
I don't know that they do it any differently in Puerto Rico. I'm not sure if it was a geographical issue, but there's a tiny little incision, and then with kind of tweezers, they pull out the vas deferens from your ball sack, which is sort of a tube which delivers sperm from your nuts through your wiener.
Why did you do this in Puerto Rico?
Because I had been invited to...
to a vasectomy?
No, I'd been invited to... they're having a mass spay and neuter event, which they wanted me to help promote and sort of get behind the cause.
This is how you promote it?
For dogs?
For dogs,
animals.
For dogs. And
you were going to promote spay and neutering by ripping out your own nuts.
100%. I said I love animals. Of course, this is my thing.
Oh.
It's a cause I believe in.
Right.
I would love to come to Puerto Rico and promote spay and neuter. And what better way to promote this cause than
There's no better way.
So I tied the two together. And I felt
amazing.
Really good
beautiful.
About it.
That is beautiful. When you think about it, I think people that I can't tell about the listeners, but I would imagine that brought a tear to everybody's eye. All right. So you're in Puerto Rico and they give you a small incision.
The only thing that actually...
Are you under anesthetic?
Yeah, local. The only thing...
Local meaning in Puerto Rico or just your nuts?
It was very similar to any kind of a dental procedure.
No,
where
it's not. No, it's not.
In that... When they numb up your mouth with the local anesthesia.
The fact that they were numbing up your mouth to work on your nuts bothers me to begin with.
Right. Like they put, similarly, they put an injection to numb up that area.
Okay.
And that was the only thing that hurt at all on any level. But with my new comedy tour, which is called the Bucket List Tour, I tell the stories. Yeah. And then after each stand-up bit, I then screen the footage of what the story was about.
Wait. You have footage of
this? Oh, yeah. I do everything. Like the story you saw me tell about shitting on the fan and then the shit's flying everywhere and everybody ran except for my girl.
That's when you knew. That's a test of love. That really is. He shit on a fan.
Yeah.
When the shit hits the fan, you know that saying.
Yeah.
He actually did it.
He's not
and
like
what
you.
Were you
he
promoting?
Films everything.
Was that to promote a charity? What did that say?
That one was just for to
An orphanage?
The personal satisfaction.
Oh, personal satisfaction. I was just saying it is an orphanage, and I told them I'll shit on a fan.
Right.
And, fans only. Only fans.
Oh, right. So, after each bit, I screen this sort of the crazy footage and that. And when I screen the vasectomy on my bucket list tour, that's one of the items on my bucket list was the vasectomy Olympics.
Is it on YouTube?
It's not on YouTube. Nothing on my bucket list tour is either allowed on YouTube or in the ether. It's
good.
It'll come out when I make the special.
The special.
But yeah, when I screen.
So you were still frozen when you were riding a horse with your nuts.
Nah, because in order to I definitely wasn't still numb, and it was definitely intense. And
after you got off the horse, why did you want to take it one step further and be a pinata? Why would you do that?
It's the Olympics.
To get more footage. You know, I also
right.
had
and also for the children. It was a birthday party. Would you work a birthday party?
The kids in the mix was it's.
And after you dropped the shit on the fan and everybody ran except this lovely lady, you said.
Well, she said, do I have shit in my vagina? And and she checked.
Right.
And that was.
If I had a buck for every time. do I have shit in my vagina?
Yeah.
Every woman that has wiped to the north instead of the south.
she was wearing a miniskirt when we filmed that. And, I mean, nobody anticipated that the shit would fly sideways.
Nobody. I haven't anticipated most of everything you've said today.
Right.
Okay, so the shit flies sideways.
And I just knew that she was the one. You know, she was wearing a miniskirt.
Have you ever been approached by Hallmark to work with? You know what? I'll keep the shit out of your vagina. I love you forever.
Right.
Did she have shit in her vagina?
She did not. She felt the need to check because her miniskirt was quite short that day. But
she wouldn't worry about getting it on her miniskirt?
She definitely got it on her miniskirt.
Was it on her face?
It wasn't on her face, no. But the whole house was speckled. We did it in the front yard.
Right, because why go in the backyard? There's not as much traffic or a good view.
Yeah.